I'd like to present my project, We Are Fighting for Our Future. Fire flickers in wood burning stove. Drops of tar look like somebody cries. The accordion sings on of love. It's about your smile and your eyes. In the fields under Moscow, the grass whispered calling your name in my ear. I would like you to hear for once how my voice sounds and longs for you here. Alexei Surkov, I decided to recite this poem to you because it shows the feelings of the poet of those events. And this project, The Battle of Moscow, will never lose its actuality. And my hypothesis is that the importance of the Battle of Moscow is unlimited and led exactly to the victory in the Great Patriotic War. The purpose and the task of my project: first, to form the idea of the course of military operation during the battles of Moscow, to describe the ratio of forces of the USSR and Germany arms in the Moscow direction in the autumn of 1941, to review the site's plans, to identify the reasons why the USSR managed to survive this battle, also to characterize its importance, and to tell about the exploits of Russian heroes. Here you can see the ratio of forces of the USSR in Germany. As you can see, the Germany had better resources and equipment. Defense of Moscow, Operation Typhoon. The general offensive of the German troops of the Central Group on the capital began on the 13th of September in 1941. Defeat of the Grand Force. Guderian's 7th Panzer Group immediately achieved serious success, and already on the 3rd of October, parts of 20 corps, motorized corps, broke right into Europe. The Azovsky border. Until the 11th of October, the insurgent troops made attempt to break through, but was unsuccessful. And only on the 12th of October, they managed to break through, but only for a short time, it was closed again. In total, more than 688,000 soldiers and veterans were trapped at Vyazma and Bryansk, and only about 85,000 managed to escape from the encirclement. From the memories of Marshal Zhukov, here you can see his quotation. The Majai's line of defense. The main line of resistance on the approaches to Moscow was the Majai's line of defense. The main reason was to firmly cover all the directions from leading to Moscow, Volkolamsk, Majaisk, Majorel Slavets, and Kolkov. Kalinin defensive operation. It was important to cover the capital from the northwest on October 17th. The Kalinin front was created on the basis of troops on the right wing on the western front. Measures of the defense of Moscow. On the 15th of October, the State Defense Committee of the USSR took the measures to strengthen the defense of the capital. The next day, the evacuation was provided of the general staff officers, military academics, and other committees. Mining of factories, power plants, and bridges was done. Here you can see Moscow citizens digging anti-tank trenches in the outskirts of the city. Here you can see the anti-tank hedgehogs on the streets of Moscow. Also Moscow citizens on the construction of the barricades. And yeah, the young men registration volunteers at the front. 17th of November 1941. It was the time of the parade, and the participants of the parade, our army, were inspired by the supreme commander. I'm going to read his words. Brothers and sisters, the whole world looks at you as a force capable of destroying the predatory hordes of German invaders. The war you are waging is a war of liberation, a fair war. Long live our glorious motherland, its freedom, its independence. The second German offensive. The second German offensive of the group Army Center on Moscow began on the 15th of September in 1941. Once again, the Moscow region was covered in bloody battles. And on the 16th of November, at the Dubosek Kurchatsk, 28 men from Panfilov's rifle division, led by junior political officer Klachkov, engaged 50 German tanks, and 24 of them were bought and shot down. Klachkov said those words: Russia is great, but there is no way to retreat. Moscow is behind us. The last rush to Moscow. In this picture, you can see Mikhail Ephraimovich Kutakov. He managed to drive away the enemy attacks, and his 10th Brigade distinguished itself in those areas. The results of the defense of Moscow. During the defensive part of Moscow, the Soviet command imposed a war of attrition. But if during the battle all the reserves of the German army were poor and exhausted, the Soviet army managed to keep their resources and forces. The Soviet counter-offensive near Moscow. On the 5th of September, the troops of the Kalinin Front, and on the 7th and 6th, the Western Front, and also the right wing of the South Western Front launched a counter-attack. And in the course of the Soviet counter-offensive near Moscow, the enemy had been driven away. The importance of Battle of Moscow. The mists of invincibility of the German army have been dispelled. The growth of the reputation and spaces in the front of peoples in the territories occupied by Germany played out again. The process of holding the anti-Hitler coalition again, and also Germany's allies, Turkey and Japan, decided not to enter the war against the USSR. The hypothesis of mine had been proved, and the importance of the Battle of Moscow is truly believed and led to victory. You can see the sources I used, especially historical literature by Zagladin and Chuvayan. Thank you for your attention.